God say, y'all. Cause I got some place to go, and I'm praying when I get there. Come on. Heaven. God say. We do not own the rights to this music that's being played. God say. Y'all go ahead and start sharing, start your watch parties, and welcome to God's Day. Pray everybody is having an amazing day. God is still blessing and keeping us and holding on to us. Have no reason to be upset, mad, or angry for no apparent reason, because you woke up your beautiful eyes today, and we grateful to the Lord for what He has done for us. Again, we do not own the rights to the music that's playing in the background. We just enjoy it and love it. That's Mary, Mary Heaven. And I'm praying when I get there, I see everyone I know. I wanna go to heaven. So I'm gonna have y'all stay with me for a couple of minutes while I put my dinner on. Come on. We about to give God His credit. Just a second. Got to start out giving Him His credit, because if without Him, we wouldn't be nothing. So, and with Him, we are everything. So we want to make sure we give Him His credit first off. Okay? Y'all give me just a second and we're going to go there. We're going to do that. Apologize. I hope you're enjoying what you're hearing thus far. All right, I think we're done. Took us a whole song, but hey, we did it. Hey, how are y'all? I'm just now seeing everybody. Guys, say welcome, welcome. No, I haven't been on here in a couple of days. Y'all know, pray for me. Anyway, welcome if this is your first time. If it's not your first time, y'all know how we do. Y'all know what goes on. I'm going to skip that because I don't even know what that was about just then. I like this song. Y'all, listen, I'm not even going to go there. She need to mind her business. Sister Lynn Bitson need to mind her business. Thank you, Miss Tracy. Come on, get out your bad space. There's no need. Listen, hold on. We're going to back up. Let me turn this down. I like this song, though. We're going to let it play in the background, though. Listen, first of all, let me give praises to God, to everything that He has done. If it hadn't been for Him, we wouldn't have woke up today, whatever time that was, whether you woke up at the crack of dawn or at noontime. We grateful to God that He has kept us and He is holding on to us and He keep on doing those amazing things for us, because He didn't have to do it. But I'm glad He showed us a brand new day. He didn't give us yesterday. If yesterday you had a bad day, He didn't give it back to you to again so you can continue to have a bad day. He gave you a new opportunity to have a greater day, to have a better day than you did on yesterday. He gave you one today. He didn't recycle the days. He didn't go back 5 years ago where you was going, you was down and out, you was depressed. you was going through some stuff and he brought you back to that same day. No, no, no. He gave you a brand new day, brand new mercy. Like, it's brand spanking new. Like, it's clean. Like, there was nothing wrong with today when you woke up. He woke you up. He came by your bed, by your bedside, your couch side, whatever you laying on, your air mattress side. And he woke you up. He said, today you're going to have a great day. I don't care if it is 4:13 in the afternoon. You're going to have a great day. You're going to have an amazing day. What has happened yesterday, leave it at yesterday. It's old, dead, and stinky. That's what my mom and sister used to tell us. Let that go. That's old, dead, and stinky. You don't have to, hey, how are you guys day? You don't have to have what you had on yesterday. Today is a brand new day to start over. Any bad things that have happened, let it go. That was yesterday. It's a brand new day. Forget about it. Pray about it. Forget about it. Leave it where it is. Move forward. God has done some amazing things for you. And when every time he wakes these up, you got an opportunity to do right, to ask for forgiveness or forgive someone, to say, I'm sorry. Lord, please forgive me. To ask for forgiveness from him, to get closer to him, to trust him even more. Because if it wasn't behind his trust that you trusted him, where would you be? You didn't trust God. We trust the chair more than we trust God. Say we don't. Say we don't trust the chair more than we trust God. Let me tell you how. You don't question if the chair gonna hold you. Whatever weight you are, whatever size you are, you don't sit there and ask the chair, are you going to be able to hold me? Are you going to, when I sit, you just go and sit down in it. We don't make sure that it's going to work or we're going to fall to the ground in front of 500 people. We trust that chair. We don't trust God like that. We got to see, well, let me check and see. I'm not sure. We got to put it on the I'm not sure status. When that chair that you don't know who made it, you don't know what material came with that, we just sit down in it when we get to it. But we trust in this chair. We trust in somebody else's building stuff over God. Think about it. Why am I going to put that trust in man and I'm not putting my trust in God? God wakes me up every day. It ain't my alarm clock. It's not me. It's not my husband, my spouse, or whomever. It's not my children that's waking me up. It's God that's doing it. Because if it had not been for him, what would I be? Would I have a roof over my head? Would I have a job to go to? Would I have some type of income coming in? If it wasn't for him, what would I be? Would I have the car to drive? Would I have water running, clean water running, and it's running appropriately? Would I have electricity? Would I have the things that I have right now if it wasn't for him? We trust in all the other things. We trust in man. We believe in everything else. But do we believe in him? That's what this song is called. I'm a believer. I trust him. In all the things that he does for me, I trust him. I know the voice of the Lord. I don't know the voice of the devil. See, the devil talks to you too. I keep telling y'all. The devil is so clever. He try to outsmart you and try to outsmart God, but we got to know the difference. When we start hearing that God, hey, how are you guys? Hey, listen. When you start hearing, listen, y'all. Y'all know my nerves get too bad. I can't. You know, I'm gonna turn it down a little bit lower, but I'm gonna still have it playing in the background because I feel like I start talking louder than that. But when things start going to a point where we think it's the Lord that's blessing us, you have to realize the Lord, the devil give you everything. He'll get you on his team. He'll give you all the desires of your heart. And I'm saying it to be funny in that manner, but really he will take care of you. The devil will take care of his people. You think it's the Lord. Well, you know what? The Lord blessed me with this. He blessed me with that. He gave me all these great things. He's on doing all this. But you ain't done nothing for him. How he gonna bless you and you haven't done nothing for him? Like, he's gonna give you all this stuff. Y'all don't mean to be all, because I talk with my hands, so this is what happens. He gonna bless you with all these things. He's gonna give you all these wonderful, hey, birthday twin, how are you guys day? He's going to bless you with all these things, but you're not doing anything for him. You was a Sunday school teacher. You won't even show up for Sunday school no more. You was cleaning the church. You won't even come clean the church no more. You was opening up the doors and having the church smelling good and smelling like pine sauce, smelling like a Saturday morning. You won't even do that no more. You was paying your tithe, and now you pay on your tithe or don't pay on them at all. You was doing all these things. Now things don't got in the way. And the Lord's been, the devil is blessing you now. It's not even the Lord no more. Because you couldn't even wait on the Lord. You thought it was him, but you couldn't, you was too impatient that you couldn't even wait on him. So now you worshiping the devil. You think you're not, but you are. Because you think the Lord's going to bless you He's not the author of confusion. That means to me, you telling me that the Lord's word is wrong. What he's telling us is saying that he's not the author of confusion. So he's not going to sit up there and try to confuse you and say, this is me that's doing this. And it's really the devil that's doing it. But the devil going to make it so pretty and nice. He's going to give you everything you've been asking for, whatever you've been praying for. He's going to give it to you because he wants you on his team. He know you ain't doing nothing for God. So he going to present all this pretty stuff to you. He going to make it out. I'm saying pretty stuff. I don't mean like no woman or nothing. But if that's your thing, hey, maybe that's what it is. He's going to give you all of these things that you want. But in the back of all of this, he said you ain't done nothing. When you think about it, what have I done for God lately? What have I presented to him to make him happy with the things that I've done? Do I know if he take me right now at 418, would he be happy? Do I know for sure that's where I'm going? Would he be happy with me if he take me right now? What have I done for him lately? I was doing this for the church. Now I don't slack off. Now I work on Sundays instead of going to church. I'm standing my ground. I'm not working on no Sunday. Find you somebody else to work on Sunday because I'm not doing it. Now you volunteering. And you supposed to be at church opening up the doors. Now you not doing any of that. Now you were sweeping the floor. Now you only sweeping at your job. But you won't sweep at the church. I don't understand. You clean up somewhere else, but you won't clean up at the church. I don't understand. I'm just asking. These are things that people may seem like they are taking advantage, and they thinking it's the Lord blessing them with things and businesses and blessings. All these blessings I got, the Lord has blessed me, but you won't slid all the way out of the church. You just ain't going. Don't even blame it on COVID. COVID is a thing of the past. And I'm saying it of the past because it don't slow down. But what I'm saying is that excuse that you're using that because of COVID, you know it's the pandemic out here. Is it really? But you was at Walmart yesterday. You was at the movies. I heard the movies don't open back up. You was at the restaurant. You was there and you had your foot up under somebody's table. You were socializing somewhere else. It wasn't your house. You was at the pool party. Listen, you was doing all those things. But when it come down to church, now we got excuses why we can't go, why we can't be there. Why I'm not able to show up. It's COVID that did this. It was COVID that made me feel. Now when COVID is over, then what's your excuse? Now you're going to say, well, I don't have a car. When the Lord bless you with a car, you wouldn't even do right. Sister so-and-so asked you to come pick up and you wouldn't even do right with your God. So what you want her to do? I didn't get on here to talk about this. Yeah, okay, please, you know, I'm not going to say forgive me because y'all know whatever is laid on my heart, I just said. Listen, let me go back for a second. Miss Tracy Green, VWA the stylist, wears these lovely earrings I have on today. I didn't have time to put no necklace on, so this is what y'all getting today. Of course, this is a South Oak Cliff High School t-shirt. I can't breathe. We've been doing this. We've been about this movement, you know? We've been about this. So this is a South Oak Cliff High School t-shirt. Hey, it is what it is. It say 2015, I think. Somewhere up under this, I can't see. Don't judge me. But anyway, check out Miss Tracy Green, VWA the stylist, where she got everything you need from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. Please check her out. I'm telling you, when she go live, you're gonna be like, oh my gosh, I need that. Yes, you do. So go ahead and buy it. Don't wait. Don't be tripping by shipping. Don't be doing none of that. Go ahead and get what you need from her because she may not get it again. You're gonna be like, I should have got them earrings. You sure should have. So I'm telling you now, she don't just have earrings of this demeanor. She has other earrings. Listen, move this hair out the way. She has other things. So these are Chanel. So if you need something like this, I have some other Chanels in there. You know, all kinds, all colors, all kinds of. Check her out. Miss Tracy Green, VWA, the stylish way. I promise you, your wife, your girlfriend, your significant other, your side chick, whatever, whoever you want to please. I don't know. I ain't in your business. I'm just saying. You want something nice to get her? For she has men item as well. So don't think she just have women stuff. You have something nice you want to get for your significant other, or for me, you know, I don't mind. Christmas is around the corner. You just want to start packing up stuff and start putting your little basket together for me. I will wait until December. I'll wait to get my gift. But she got everything you need from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. Don't forget to check her out. Miss Tracy Green, she's on here, VWA the stylish way. She has a whole situation going on. Y'all know I say situation or gathering or whatever. Whatever I say, y'all know what it mean. Y'all use context clues when you was in school, so you know what it mean. Okay? So, check her out. VWA, the stylish way. She got everything you need from top of your head to the sole of your feet. The reason why I said top of your head, because she got like headbands, she got hats, she got scarves, she got necklaces, she got earrings, she got rings, she got shades, she got whatever. What you need? She said everything but half. Get at her. Okay? VWA, the stylish way with Miss Tracy Green. I promise you won't be disappointed with your product. She have shirts, she have dresses, she have shoes, she have socks, bracelets, purses, bags, purse charms, what you want, she got it. Okay? If I'm sending you there, that means I'm telling you she's a great person to shop with. Okay? I won't send you nowhere. She even got face masks. Like, I know y'all see me posting about the face mask. Check her out. Okay? You need a cute face mask. You might as well go and get y'all colors. It's going to be a minute before we start wearing them. So go ahead and get you one that you need and find you something cute that you can breathe in. And the one so far that I got from her, I can breathe, is me. Okay? Because I don't go nowhere. So I go to church and every now and again we go to a restaurant or something. But, you know, trying to sit and breathe, or I go to the nail shop. But sitting and trying to breathe and walk and all that, it's a little much. Okay? So, but I still get something because you have to go into these places, the businesses, and you have to wear a mask. So, if you need a nice place to get a mask, cute and all, check out Miss Tracy Green with VWA, the stylish way. I promise you, she has everything you need. I will not say nothing about Amazon anymore. I can't say nothing about that. But check her out. I promise you won't be disappointed with the products that you receive from her. And she has great customer service and she's on point. Her daughter, Gabby Williams, is also, she also has Gab's Goodies. Let me get it right. Check her out. Gabby Williams, she also has Heaven Scent. She's a cleaning organization company. So you need something clean, garage, closets, need your clothes washed, any of that stuff, check her out. Y'all know I'm sure everybody, you go to GodSay81.com, click on announcements. It has plenty of businesses that are there. Gabby's is on there. She is with Heaven Scent. What you need clean, what you need done, what you need organized, she got you. From the front door to the back door, from the side door to the other side of the door, from left to right, from up and down, she got you. What you need, she posts pictures and everything. So you can see what she need. Her name is Gabby Williams. Check her out. She's on GodSay81.com and she's on Facebook. Check her out. And she has Gab's Goodies and accessories and more, I think. Something of that demeanor. Hey. Check her out. When she go live, you click on that little situation, turn it on. When she go live, you'll know. Okay? Y'all, I'm going to tell y'all about some more people. But, listen, she is great at what she does. I'm telling you, if I'm telling you about these people, I recommend them. I enjoy their customer service, their love, their support, all of that. I told y'all about the story behind, you know, Lord will start removing people from you and he starts sending new people, but we got to be willing to let people go that don't mean you no good. You holding on to these folks thinking that it's going to be get better. Some people just set in their ways and they not going to change. But you know what? You can't change nobody, but you can change you. You can stop you from acting a fool. You can stop you from being that person. You don't have to, because somebody going down to that level don't mean you have to go there. Be better than that. You're better than that. You don't have to stoop down to nobody's level. You ain't got to get on the same, you know, have that same anger they have. Their anger is different from your anger. I'm on a different level now. I'm on a different love now. And people is not on that ride that God has set for you, that path God is putting you on, that same pathway that he got you looking forward to. Y'all read that blog. Don't go back. What you looking back there for? There's nothing back there for you to look at. There, you can't even get back there. What you reaching back there for? It's nothing. All this is right here. I'm trying to go after all this I can reach. And I can't reach back here behind me and try to grab nothing. It's not working. It don't work. So guess what? I look ahead. I reach for the in front of me. I try to reach what's in front of me. And I go after that. And people that are not going this way with me, it's time for you to go. It means it is what it is. I can't hold on to that because that means that's a stumbling block for me. That means there's a bump in the road and I don't need you to be that bump. I'm overcoming that. I'm moving forward. And if you don't want to get on this same bus ride with me, you got to go. And I'm okay with that. The Lord started removing people. He started bringing new folks into your space, into your area, into your life. Enjoy that. Get on that. And you just be trying to figure out why, Lord, why? Why did you, and my sister told me, you don't need no answer. You don't need no answer. Move on. You don't need no explanation on why. You not going to get no why. They not going to tell you a why. And if they ain't going to tell you a why, what you holding on to that for? Your path, the way you need to be going is ahead of you. They not on that same level with you. And people do that to you because they're jealous of you. They don't know how to move forward. They got problems with their own lives. They don't sound like the path that you on, or you on the, since you on that path and the Lord hasn't taken them there, they still holding on to some stuff they need to let go. And they haven't let go of it yet. You gonna let it go. You learn to live with it and you moving on. They ain't on that path with you. Let it go. She told me, she said, you don't need no explanation. Keep going forward. keep reaching for what God got you for, the road he got you on, the thing he's setting you up for, that elevation, because Bishop talked about elevation a couple of years ago. When he became Bishop, oh my. Oh, it was horrible when it came down to it. The folks you say that's your friend, that support you and have your back. When he became Bishop, oh, the talk was something. Folks that just started talking and saying something, everything. Guess what? I had to pull my husband to the side. Let me tell you something. Don't worry about that. They wasn't your friend from the jump. And I've made a post, I did, and it probably wasn't right at the time, but I felt like it was. Instead of you talking about him on social media without attaching his name, because I'm that person, tag the person you're talking about. Tag them. That way we can go ahead and rectify this, but we don't have to do it on social media. My thing was, if you wasn't here to help him, first of all, you was never his friend. Second of all, if you was really here to help somebody that you know that needed the assistance, what you should have done was call them, because the number haven't changed. Been the same for 17, 18 years. We've been having the same number. The number hasn't changed. So you should have called and said, hey, you got that done wrong, or this is done wrong. This is what it should say, or it shouldn't say. And move on from that. But friends don't talk about friends and put friends down and do subliminal messages, because I'm that person. I'm not the third-party messenger. I'm the upfront person. Let's talk about it. Let's put it out there on the table. Why we got to talk about having subliminal messages? Cut that out. What we doing? Like, we grown. We 87. Let's move on. No, we not. Y'all know I'm throwed off. Hey, how are you guys today? Y'all know I'm throwed off.
Listen, all I'm saying is, sorry, y'all, I'm trying to get this pan. All I'm saying is, because I want to have.
Sorry. But you have people that are like that. You have people that are like that, to where they're not, and it's okay when you have people that don't want to be on that same bandwagon with you, and you got your supporters. You know who's going to support you and who not, but don't dwell on the people that are not supporting you. Don't dwell on the people that are not helping you, that don't want to do anything for you. Don't dwell on that, because that's that bad vibe. That's what they want. She that mad at me that she don't even dwell on that. Move on. Okay, baby, that's fine. You move on. When you ask people to do stuff for you and they don't give you no answer, they don't call you back, they don't text you back, guess what? Move on. Quit holding on to that stuff. It may bother you, but move on. That stuff will eat you up if you allow it to. What you're not going to do is have somebody in the hospital behind your foolishness. That's not going to work. That's not going to happen. See, you got to learn how to remove things that don't mean you any good. Let those things go that's holding you down. Did you feel bound to? Listen, this is not, if this is not Jesus's work, I don't want to do it. Well, I'm not going to sit here and hold on to people that don't want to do better or don't want to change, or we're stuck in that rut. Oh, that's the way we was raised. That's the way it got to be. Who said it? Like, who said your way was the right way? Leaving it at the way you was raised don't mean it was always the correct way. We have to realize that. And because you're older don't mean because you're what you said means that that's right. Older people can be taught too. It's never too late to be taught. You can't, I mean, because I know some people say it in their ways and they're just like, I'm just not going to change. I'm 82 and it's just, that's the way it's supposed to be. You're supposed to wear stockings on Sunday morning. I just don't. So don't judge me. Yeah, I was raised to do it, but yeah, first Sunday, okay? All them other Sundays, listen, it don't happen. My mama probably will get on to me by now, but you know, hey, it is what it is. I'm not that person to wear them every Sunday. I just don't think they go with every shoe. That's just my opinion. And, you know, the situation, I got a video. I know y'all probably seen it. A young lady fell. She went to the nail shop. She told the people not to put the lotion up under her feet. And they did. She put her shoes back on and fell in the parking lot. I'm just saying, stockings is not made for every shoe. So, yeah, I just don't wear them. So, anyway, that's not the point. Oh, I am fixing fish. I'm baking fish. And we having baked fish and salad tonight. So, yeah, that's dinner, is baked fish and salad. So that's what we doing today. But I just want us to make sure that the things that God has set us up for, the things that God is looking for us to do better in, that we are actually looking to do better in. Like, it's a lot going on out here. And a lot of times it's just time out for all this foolishness and plan and all this extra stuff that we do. It's time out for that. And we haven't realized that yet. I don't know. Sometimes it may take a lot. It may take a lot for us to realize it, for it to sink in and you know, fill it into our brain and say, hey, it's time out for that. Like, I'm old enough now to where I realize some things are not the same the way they used to be. I seen last night the guy that I always go live when something happens in our city, and when he went live, he said there was two at one time. And you never know where life would take you. Never know where death may take you, when it's going to take you. Let me say it like that. You never know when death may take you. So all the extra stuff that we do, people are going through some real life issues. And you, because people smiling and they look like they having a good time. I told you a long time ago, we could be whoever we want to on social media. You want to be? I said I want to be Michael Jackson the other day. He dead and gone. He is. But we want to be, we can be anybody we want to be. And who can stop us? Because we on social media. Who's going to stop you and say, folks going to say, nah, you lying, you not Michael Jackson. I know that. But in my mind, that's what I'm saying. Some people's mind work like that, that they feel like they're different from everybody else. Who am I to judge you and say, why are you posting it? Because that's not really you. That's who you feel like you are. You want to be Cher today. I don't know much about Cher, but I think we have the same birthday, maybe. I'm not sure. But why am I dwelling or mad with you? Because you want to be Cher today. That's who you are, alter ego. I don't know. But people want to be whatever they want to be, but I can't let that bother me because you want to be somebody else. That's you, baby. That's your life. That's the life you want to live. Cool, right ahead. It's fine. I just want us to, I thought I had some seasoning, but I guess I don't. I just want us to make sure that we are on God's team, that we know who he is. Matters all the other stuff and all the arguing and fussing and fighting and these folks is out here killing each other. And yeah, by the way, this is Bishop seasoning. It may just like it's in this bottle, but this is his seasoning that he, and I just fix it up the way he, you know, that's the way he fix, he cook. If y'all haven't had none of this Bishop seasoning or some barbecue we had made at the church, Jesus. But I'm putting it on this fish today. But that's what we're going to have, is baked fish and salad today. And this don't really take long. I'm going to cut this one because this one is big. I'm going to cut this one. But God has been so good to all of us. I mean, I say that even when everything else is going wrong in your life and we feel like we don't have a way to turn to, just think about the goodness of the Lord on how he has just brought you from a mighty long way. Just think about the smallest thing as him waking you up. That's the greatest gift, you to be able to breathe. You know, there's some people that have to have face masks, and I'm not talking about the ones we have to walk around and go inside of different businesses or whatever. I'm talking about they have to wear the oxygen tanks in order just to breathe. And you're talking about they got to wear oxygen tank and put on a mask. That's a lot. But you're able to just breathe on your own. No machine is helping you. And we complaining, we arguing, we fighting, we doing all this, we shooting at folks, we ready to go and rob somebody. We doing all of these things. Why? And people out here struggling trying to breathe. You got folks out here can't even bathe themselves, but you took your own shower. You bathed your own self. You took a shower by yourself. No one helped you. You did that. Nobody else. See, you didn't have to call nobody and have them to come brush your teeth for you. You brush your own teeth? And I'm out here doing what? And folks out here struggling with some real life issues. They can't even raise up their arm. You can move all the activities of your limbs. It may be sore. You may have arthritis. You may can't move your fingers like you want to. You may can't even clap and put your hands together or make. But you're able to do something. Some people can't even do that. They may have one arm. I have a classmate of mine that has one arm, still looking to work. I said classmate, so which means I told you where you were, I graduated in. So young. But he's still striving to work. He's still trying to do regular people things, but you won't even do anything, and you have all the activities of your lips. Everything is still attached that you were born with. But people out here that have disabilities can't do anything. They can't do anything. But you got it all. Some people don't even have hair on their head. You have hair. And I don't mean it like you have hair like you want to cut it all off. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about people that have went through their medication is causing their hair to fall out. But you have your own hair. But you complaining? Come on now. You got people out here that can't even hear. Like they're sitting up there just looking, trying to reach your lips, and now they got to try to reach your lips with a face mask on. So they already, they struggling double time. And you can sit up here and you can hear. You have your tongue. You can talk. You can make words. You can make sounds. And folks are struggling to talk. You can see. You may have assistants like me and wear glasses, and that's all right. But you can see. You have a job. I'm just talking about little things that people take for granted that we don't even see, and we complaining. Oh, I can't go get my nails done. But these people don't even have nails. Like, it's like really dumb stuff. Like, for real, you complain about I can't even get my hair done. But some people don't even have hair to get done. I'm just saying, these are things that people that are just, they take it and they just like, oh, well, you know, it should be, and everything have to be about me. What about me? What is me? And you're just like, come on, think about somebody else's well-being. Think about somebody else's feelings. Think about some other stuff that people are maybe dealing with. You're not the only one. When God made you, he didn't stop with you. They made other people. So you can't make things always about you. It got to always be around your, what you want done. Let me put this fish in the oven, y'all. Hold on. I got to get this stuff. But I'm just saying, just be grateful that God has been blessing you and stop complaining. What you complaining for? What are you complaining for? Listen, God has been too good to us, and we complain about stuff that we don't need to be complaining about. It's folks in the hospital that wishing that they can go home. I'm seeing rip such and such, rip auntie, rip uncle, rip daddy, rip brother. And you ain't said rip to nobody. Like, nobody this year. You ain't said rip to nobody that you, maybe somebody that you know that you've seen, but I'm talking about somebody close to you. Like, my sister passed in April. So that was a, you know, situation for me. But other people that have been around, and you ain't been at the funeral home making arrangements for nobody. God been blessing you. He been keeping you and your family. You been out and about. You been at Walmart. You been at the grocery store. You been at the Target. You been at the gas station. You done been to the car lot. You done a lot of stuff. But you still covered. God has still been blessing you. He's still been covering you. He's still been taking care of you. He's still been watching over you as you traveling down. People have gotten killed trying to assist somebody else on the side of the road. They car don't stop at somebody, and they don't got killed. Folks drunk driving. Folks is out here doing some crazy stuff. But the Lord's been keeping you, and you complaining. No need for complaints. Think about somebody else. I think that was Sister Lynn's co-worker that got killed the other day, Sunday morning. The drunk driver hit her and killed her. She got 3 kids. Now her kids got to sit here and cry over their parent, over something somebody else did. It wasn't her doing. She was doing, trying to help somebody else, and this happened to her. So then what? And we complaining? This woman, her kids don't have a parent anymore. Now what? Your kids at home. Your kids are there. They're doing, you know, whatever. But you have all your children. You're not burying your children. Your children are not burying you. And we complaining? When you think about being mad, angry, upset, doing harm to someone or something, going out and wilding out for whatever reason, think about how God has been blessing you. And if you can't think about yourself or God, how he's been blessing you, think about how he's been blessing your children. When you can't think about how he's been blessed, just think about where you're living at. that you at least got covered. It's been raining the past 2 or 3 days, and I think it's supposed to rain up until tomorrow. Don't look like, I'm looking out my window, don't look like it's raining right now. But you got a roof over your head. What color, I'm color purple, what they say is going to rain on your head? It ain't going to rain on your head because you in the house, you covered. But think about the people that's sleeping outside on the curb. They're sleeping on the park benches or sleeping outside on the dark bus benches or whatever, downtown. But you covered. What you complaining for? What's your complaint for? What are you complaining for? God's been taking great care of you. Great care of you. And you're complaining for what? He's been covering you all week long, all day long. And don't get me wrong, you're going to have some problems and some stuff that's going to happen. Yeah, true enough. But with all that going on, what you complaining for? God's been just absolutely too great to you, like too awesome to you, to where you complaining. Think about somebody else's danger. Somebody got to go and visit their child. And I'm not talking about a child like a 17, 16-year-old child. I'm talking about a child like a 3-year-old, a 4-year-old. They have to go and sit in the hospital if they allow them to because of this virus. If they allow them to, they'll be able to go and be there for their child. If they can't, then what? They're a nervous wreck, and they don't know what the outcome going to be. But your kids are at home with you. Their child is fighting leukemia or fighting sickle cell or fighting anything else, but your child is not. Your child is healthy. They may get on your nerves. They may be doing a whole lot of up stuff, you know, whatever. But your child is being taken care of, being watched over. The Lord's been keeping them, keeping you, because you don't have to be at the hospital with them day and night. They having a crisis. It ain't you, but it's your child. But the Lord has been blessing you. He's keeping you. And we're complaining. What are we complaining for? Why are we hurting? Why are we doing all this extra stuff for? No need for that. And it could be you. Easily as it is them, it can be you. Sometimes people don't find out health issues until later on in life. But when it gets you, it can get you and it can take you so fast. You may be embarrassed. You may be hurt by it. You may meet, some people get angry with God. But those things can happen to you, but God has been keeping you. So what are we complaining for? What's the complaint for? God's been too amazingly great to each and every last one. I told you, every time he wake up your eyes, he's been good to you. He's been great to you. And there is no need for all the extra stuff. There's no need for all the hurt. Love everybody. I know it's hard for some people. You just be like, oh, Lord, it's hard for you to love. I know some people wreck your nerves to where it's just like, ooh, it's a little much. It's a little hard for me to love you right now. But you still love them in spite of what they've done wrong to you. In spite of how they hurt you. Yeah, I'm a little late on that. But God has been, the stuff that he's been doing for you. Just think about somebody else where you could be. You could be where sitting in that same seat somebody's sitting in. You could be on that front row of that church come this weekend or tomorrow going to awake. You can be that person that can easily be you. Somebody's been doing that. Some people been doing it pretty much every week because they've been having deaths after deaths after deaths. But the Lord's keep watching your family. Remember how you treat people. Remember how you get, how you treat people. Remember I had more than I thought, so I had to get another pen. remember how you treat people. Remember how you do people, because I wore that shirt the other day and said karma, because it can. It can. Hard as it hit them, it can hit you even harder. And my sister and my mama used to say the same thing, make you laugh, make you cry. And that was definitely true. They used to tell us that all the time. The same thing make you laugh will make you cry. And it's absolutely true. So be careful about how you treat people and with the things you say to people, because it can hurt. I know they used to tell you, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt. Them words hurt. They do. They may not hurt you physically, but those words hurt.
I'm rewashing my hands.
Okay. Yeah, words hurt. Listen. Listen, come on, Miss Felicia, putting that season on some boiled eggs. Listen. Don't start nothing in here. I'm trying to do, you know what? I'm about to fix some eggs for my for our salad anyway. Let me see if this salad I have require eggs. I don't know. But if it don't, but this seasoning, it goes on everything. It goes on everything.
Everything.
A couple of weeks ago, I fixed some oxtails. Oh, they were so good. Like, my kids, I didn't even know they ate oxtails like that. But they was like, you fixed some oxtails? I was like, yeah. Man, it wasn't even that much left. And I was like, I really didn't fix it for y'all, but okay. I really didn't fix it for them, but it was fine. They ate some of it. They was like, oh, those were so good. So I put some of it. Excuse me. I put some of it on my I seasoned it with his seasoning on the oxtails, and my kids was like, Mom, I didn't know you was gonna. I really didn't, because you know oxtails is expensive. So if you don't eat it, don't play around with it, because oxtails is expensive. So that'll be reading shortly. It'll start smelling real good in here in about 10 minutes. Because I used to didn't eat baked fish. I'm a picky eater. Folks that know me know that. And they just, you don't eat nothing. You may think that I don't eat anything. I eat. It's just, I'm picky. It's a lot of stuff I don't eat. People think I should eat, and that's probably why folks call me bougie. I'm not, though. I don't feel like I'm bougie, but hey, some people call me that. I'm not gonna, they're gonna leave a message. Some people call me bougie, but they feel like since I don't eat anything, I used to eat baked fish, so that was the point of this story. I used to eat baked fish until my husband fixed the baked fish, and he was like, "Try," and I was like, "It's just don't look done." Like I don't eat seafood, so only seafood I eat is catfish. So don't. All that other stuff, crawfish and all that extra stuff you got to break up and dig in. Not eating that. It's too much. First of all, it stinks to me. And yeah, I'm not eating it. So I don't eat seafood. So when he first started doing the baked fish, I was like, he was like, try it. And I was like, you know how I don't try new stuff. Don't judge me. I just don't try new stuff. I don't do all this extra stuff that people be doing. Girl, let's go. We went on a cruise some years back, and he was on there eating red snapper and all that. I don't understand why it's red. I don't eat that. Don't judge me. I'm going to do a blog on stuff about me eating, my picky eating. I'm going to do a blog on that. But, yeah, he got me to eat the fish, and I enjoyed it. Sad to say, I did. I enjoyed that. I was like, I'll give it a chance. So, once a week, we started eating this baked fish and salad, pretty much baked fish and salad or whatever. We was eating it. Then we stopped eating it for a little while. And then we'll bring it back maybe once every 2 weeks or whatever. So putting his seasoning on it is the reason why I eat it. Let me just say that. That's the only reason why I eat it, is because of his seasoning. If it hadn't been for that, I wouldn't have ate it. Because when folks be doing, they order salmon and all that at the salmon crook, it's the smell for me. I'm out. So I don't eat it. And I know folks say that, they told me that yesterday. My family's like, oh, you bougie. You don't eat nothing. Well, I'm sorry. I don't eat buffet food, cafeteria food. I'm out. Drinking milk, eating all. Yeah, I don't. Don't judge me. But I'm gonna do a whole blog on my eating, my picky eating. But anyway, move on from there, because I know folks gonna be like, oh my gosh, like, yeah, I know. I don't know if I was worse or my sister was worse. One of us, but we picky eaters. And we didn't eat nothing. So she didn't eat nothing. I pray that y'all have been enjoying the blogs that is on guysday81.com. Sorry, y'all. I hope y'all have been enjoying those blogs that's been coming out. I'm doing better. We'll keep putting out more. I did a midweek encouragement blog on yesterday. So if you have not went to read that, the subscribers, I told about that first. But it's out there on guysday81.com under blog. Lady C's blog. I think one of the blog pages I may just go ahead and delete. I'm not sure yet. We're gonna pray hard. But I'm thinking about it either way it go. But I pray that y'all have been enjoying those blogs. More of them, like I said, more personal blogs will come out. I will do. And one of them will be about my picky eating. Folks gonna judge me, and I know they are. Yeah, my husband's just like, oh my gosh, you don't eat anything. And I'm like, yeah. Because y'all know I don't eat big burgers. Like, I'm going to get a Whataburger Jr., number 7 with cheese, Sprite no ice, or sweet tea no ice. And I'm going to get the spicy ketchup to dip my fries in, and I want a lemon pie. That's it. Like, you don't have to give me a number 1. I don't want a Whataburger, because I'm not going to eat the whole thing. I'm going to eat like half and get the other half away. Why buy, pay $9-$10 for a burger I'm not going to eat, and I could just pay $5 for a whole meal and eat all of that. And I'm good. Like, why are we buying all this food? So anyway, he was just like, you need to get you a grown person burger. That's grown enough for me. It's a waste of money. So I'm like, you got, these kids can finish it. But if they not with me, why am I stressing over? Not doing it. So anyway, that's not the point of this story. So I'll move on. I will do some more blogs. And of course, any subscribers that are on the guysday81.com website will get the information first, to let you all know that a new blog has been posted. I want to get down to doing them daily. And right now we're up to 2 times a week. So I do a weekly encouragement. This week, yesterday I just thought about it. I was like, hey, I could do a daily, midday or midweek encouragement. So you'll see more as they come out, you'll know. If you already subscribe to the website, then you already have the information. You'll get this. It's already smelling good. I told you. It already smells like it's ready. It's not ready. It's just the seasoning on it. And that, listen, like you want to eat the herb. Anyway, so the blog. So please check it out. Guysday81.com. Check out the blog. Check out the announcements page. If you have any information that needs to be uploaded to the announcements page, like the church, your business, your event, any nonprofit organization information, it can definitely be uploaded to guysday81.com. I've seen mutual friends and networking happening on the guysday81.com. So go ahead and be a part of that. There are people out there for different businesses that you may need or someone you know may need. There is a link there or a button there. All you have to do is click on that particular person's button, and it'll take you directly to their website, their Twitter page, their Instagram page, their Facebook page, whatever they have. It'll send you directly there. So that's all been set up. All you have to do is send me your information. You can inbox it to me on this page or on my Guysday page, or you can email me, guysday81@gmail.com, and let me know what it is and say, hey, could you post this? Now, I will say, if it's a church, please make sure you're not the pastor. Make sure you have permission from your pastor to upload it, because I want to make sure that it's done decently and in order. I do have one I need to upload, but it's all about, it's free. It's all about just making sure we're supporting each other and one another. The word of God is free. Like, it doesn't cost you anything to spread the love of God out. Everybody wants to charge everybody for every little bitty thing, and that's not the way it should be. God will bless you in the end. We don't have to always get paid for every little bitty.
I'm back. We got disconnected. I'm back. Y'all come back on in. Ain't gonna be long in too much longer anyway. I was gonna say the end of what I was saying. Letting y'all know to continue to check out the website. If you haven't already, go ahead and be a subscriber. I made it so easy for you to become a subscriber to the Guys Day 81.com website. You can text GD81. GD81. Text it to 66866. Send in your name and email address, and it would automatically add you to our email subscription list, so you can receive exclusive information. You can go ahead and be a subscriber to the website, and there would be like different drawings and stuff that I would do to get you involved with GodSay81.com, but you will have to be a subscriber. It's so easy. There are multiple ways that you can become a subscriber. One, of course, is texting. You can text GD81 to 66866. Put your name and email address in, or whatever information is going to. I think that's all it's going to ask for. You know, I don't need your firstborn and all of that extra information. Just your name, email address, and we can get you on to our website subscribers list, and then you can go ahead and you can start receiving information, new blog posts, new products that may come out, anything that's dealing with God's Day. You will get that information first before it's being uploaded or shared to any social media platform. You'll be the first to know. And then I would just do giveaways or drawings just for the subscribers for GodSay81.com. Now, if you're already receiving emails from GodSay81.com, you do not have to subscribe again. You can stay. You don't have to do it, because it's only going to allow you to do your email address one time. So once you've done it that first time, like Miss Felicia, I got you. You don't even have to be back on there. You don't have to subscribe again. You don't have to do the texting. Any of that. You're already a part of the, let's see. Just got this. Normally I don't have this on there. But as I was stating, you don't have to, if you're already a subscriber, the texting does not bother, it doesn't apply to you. Yeah, it kicked us off. Hey, how are you, Pastor God's Day? So for those that are not email subscribers to GodSay81.com website, this is your opportunity to do it, and you can do it quick and easy. Text GD81 for God's Day 81 to 66866. It's gonna ask for your name, email address, send it in. How's your family? How's your wife doing? Send it in. We will give you, you will get started receiving exclusive information from God's Day. New blogs, new products, all those good things. Speaking of new products, the journals are on the way, like almost here. So for those that have already pre-ordered your journals, I will send them, if they come in tomorrow, I will send them off tomorrow or Saturday. So you will have them one day next week. If they come Saturday and it comes after the post office closed, I will mail them on Monday. Well, can't mail them Monday because Monday's a holiday. I will have to mail them on Tuesday. So preferably they come in tomorrow so I can mail them tomorrow or Saturday. So, hey, lady, how are you guys' day? Listen, I'm calling everybody whisperers, okay? Because originally guys' day started out as whispers in the pews. So I'm going to leave it at whispers. So when I get on here and I say, guys, say whispers, y'all already know what it's about. Okay? Y'all just, we talk. We whisper. We have a good time. We socialize. We love the Lord. We love Jesus. We love to have a good time. We help each other out. We're here for support. Mutual friendships and relationships have started up on God's Day. And I love it. You know, in other places it has started up as well. So, y'all know I tell y'all about any and everybody. If I recommend them, that means they are good people to go to. First of all, go to GuysDayA1.com. Be an email subscriber. Start today. If you are not on that list, hey, how are you, Guys Day Whisperers? Anyway, if you have not been a part of our Guys Day email subscribers list, please do so today. It's so easy. So easy. I have three ways you can do it. First way, text GD81 to 66866. Again, GD, God's Day, 81 to 66866. It's going to ask for your name and email address. Send that in. You're going to be automatically added onto our email subscribers list. Easy. Or you can go to the GodsDay81.com website. It's going to do a pop-up, and it's going to ask you to subscribe. Put your name and email address there. That's way number two. It's going to make sure you're not a robot, you know, make sure you're human. And then the other way is go to the bottom page of the home screen. And at the bottom, it's going to have a little form down there that says email subscriber, subscribe here, whatever. Put your name, email address there. It's three ways. Easy. One, two, three. Pick one, sign up. You get exclusive information on anything that goes on with God's Day. But what I was saying was the God's Day journals are on the way. I got an email saying they'll be there. And if they come before the weekend is up, Monday is a holiday. So if it comes tomorrow or Saturday, if you pre-order already, I will send them if they come in time before the mail stop on tomorrow, before the post office closes tomorrow, then I'll mail them off tomorrow. If not, it'll be Saturday that I mail them off. So if you want to be a part of this first part, go ahead and you can order yours at GodsDay81.com under store. Now we got God's Day t-shirts too. So Miss Felicia, I know I got to send your shirt too. She won a t-shirt a couple of weeks ago. So I'm just going to send all yours into one. So you won't, you know, you'll get your journal and your shirt all together. But you can go on there and you can order your shirt. Sizes small to extra large. If you need a bigger size, let me know. But I think on the website, it goes up to extra large. And then you can get your journals. Now, I did the pre-order journals for the email subscribers first because they are subscribers. They're VIP, like. So I send it to them first. I'm only ordering a certain amount for now. And if I need to order more, I will. But the ones that have already pre-ordered, I will send those off as soon as possible. So get on that list. Get on the email subscribers list because I'm going to do something just for email subscribers. So don't miss out. Back to what I was saying about being on the announcements page. If you have a church or a pastor for church, you have an event coming up, you have a business, you have a nonprofit organization, please send me your information. GodsDay81@gmail.com. GodsDay81@gmail.com. Send me your information and say, hey, this is when we have church, or this is when we go live, this is when we have Bible study. Bam, I put your information on there. You got a business. Hey, this is when I go live. This is my link to my website. This is my whatever. Bam, it's on there. So all that information is there. You're welcome. God's Day is just a platform, but it's for everybody. You got information you need. I have a young friend of mine that sent me some information for anyone that's looking for a job. So I'm going to post that on the website. You need a job? You need a job being a tax preparer? Let me know. I will post this information on the website, GodsDay81.com, and I will put it out there for you to apply. She's looking for people that she can train to be tax preparers. So if you're interested in that, I will post that information so you can get in contact with her, and she can assist you more with that. So if you know of anybody that's doing hiring, any of that kind of stuff that is looking for jobs or whatever, let's help each other by putting this information out there. I'll put it on the website. Again, long as it's not any cussing, twerking, dancing, nakedness, drinking, smoking stuff, I don't mind posting it. We don't post negative. We don't post. We don't advertise any of that. If you got a good business you're trying to get out there, you just throwing out, you got some stuff you're trying to sell, whatever, we can put your website on there. We can put your link out there. I told you, I'm just the host of God's Day, but the God's Day is for everybody. We're a part of God. We're a part of every day. So, God's Day, it's a part of all of us. So, any kind of way we can be helpful, go out there and read those blogs. There's plenty of blogs. I think I've been doing better with posting them and updating them as much as I possibly can. Prayerfully that all of these blogs that are being put out there have been helpful to you. They're encouraging to you. One day I will get it to where I'll put some out there daily. But for the time being, at least regular blogs will be like once or twice a week. And then I will do right now a weekly blog and a midweek blog. So we working on some stuff. I told you I'm still revamping some things and I'm still bringing some more stuff to God's Day. Which is I'm excited about. Is there anything, if there's anything that I can help with to get everybody on the same page or to get closer to God or to be in prayer with you about or whatever, let me know. We're here for love and support and to support each other by any means necessary. I love that the fact that things have been, folks have learned how to get closer to one another. It's not about animosity or about hatred or you did this to me or pointing fingers, you didn't give me my money or whatever. We've learning how to grab our sister or brother by the hand, by the arm, by the phone, since most of us is just we haven't met up personally, but being there for each other. And if it's by doing this, by being on social media, doing a live or doing any of those things to reach somebody that may be in need, they may be down. You don't know what people are dealing with. You're behind a phone. You're behind an iPad or tablet or whatever, a computer. You're behind something that they don't know what you're dealing with on a day-to-day basis. So if nobody knows, why be mean? Why be unruly? Why be hurtful to somebody when we can, as a whole, grab somebody by the hand or by the arm and support them in any way? It doesn't hurt. I tell y'all that all the time. It hurts nothing to push share. To share somebody's life that is doing something positive, they're sharing, they're trying to feed their family, trying to take care of their house, and you're jealous and mad or because you didn't think of it first or because you can't afford to do it or you just not doing it and you won't share their information. It takes nothing. It takes nothing. What did it hurt? Did it cost you anything to put share? You don't want people to know that somebody that y'all talked about together, that you shared their information. You know folks will do it. Y'all talk about the person together, and then because you went and shared it, oh, so you gonna share her stuff? So that's the way we are. That's what we do. We get mad at the other person because somebody else shared it. Because y'all talked about the person, you dogged the person out. Now you sharing, the other one sharing, and you mad at them. It's too much. It's too much going on out there. So because of these things that are going on, and because of so much is happening, that's why I said we can just grab each other by the arm, by the hand, by the phone, through Messenger, through Facebook, whatever, and assist and help each other out the best way that we can, and be there for each other and support each other. Support. It smells good in here, don't it? Did you say it at me? Did you say it at me? What is this? Come back here. You ain't give me no kiss.
You want to kiss me?
I do want to kiss you. Why would I not want to kiss you?
Yeah, right.
Why would I not want to kiss you? Thank you. Ah! Listen. Ah!
Putting that front on, but I'm supposed to
say Whatever. Don't judge me. Let me tell you something, how you get your life in order. Y'all heard everything I said. Don't forget about the podcast. Guys, they got a podcast too. Y'all know we on all kind of podcast platforms. Apple, Google, iHeart, Spotify. A lot of them. I'll post them. Don't worry about that. Y'all know about the email address, guysday81@gmail.com. Use that email. It's fine. You know about the website, guysday81.com. Use the website. It's fine. Don't forget about Facebook. We're on Facebook. We're on Instagram. We're on Pinterest. We're on Twitter. Don't forget about any of that. That's fine. But let me tell you how I get you. Don't forget about these earrings that I got from Miss Tracy Green with VWA, the Stylish Way. Don't forget that. It's absolutely amazing, these earrings. Very gorgeous. Very good. I like the way they kind of, and they like a banner, you know? Advertising like a banner. I like that. That's cute. But I'm going to help y'all out on something. Don't tell too many people, because if I go there and it ain't none, I'm going to have a whole problem. These brownies from Wingstop. I told my husband when he got out, I cooked. So I asked him when he got out from work to bring me two brownies. I had one this morning. Don't judge me. I had one of these brownies this morning, but I needed two more. I'm done talking about that. So, as I was stating, don't forget to check out all these things, y'all. Share. Help support and be there for somebody else. Stay encouraged. I'll be back tomorrow. We're going to do something tomorrow. Prayerfully, these journals come in tomorrow. From my understanding, they should be in like really, really soon. And if they are, for those that pre-order, I will put them in the mail ASAP. That way you can go ahead and start receiving your journal and doing whatever you do with them, however you feel, start writing out your prayers, your goals, your thoughts, any of those things. That's what those goals are for. So visit GodsDay81.com. Check it out. The products are under store on GodsDay81.com. T-shirts and journals for now. Do know we're working on some other stuff. But for now, those are there. And oh, something else I was getting ready to tell y'all about that. Check out the blogs. Read the blogs. Leave your comments on the blog. Subscribe to the email subscription list. All those good things. So just browse around in the website. And hey, I see you in a hot minute. How are you, Whisperer? How are you? But don't forget to go and check it out. So podcast, website, email, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest. Yeah. So all those things we are a part of. I enjoy, I pray that y'all continue to enjoy your day. Hi, my handsome brother. That's my brother, y'all. Hi. Whisperers. Guys, say, listen. Anthony, don't judge me, because you know I don't eat nothing, right? I know y'all already know that. Whatever. That's my husband say the same thing. Let me turn y'all on to something. These brownies from Wingstop. They are awesome. This, and the fact that I got two of them. Actually, this is my third one, because I had one this morning and I just needed two more. Keontae went somewhere and I said, when y'all stop out, if y'all stop out, when you stop, bring your mama two brownies. He talking about what? Bring me two brownies. My husband, he came home with two brownies. I don't ask for much. Two brownies. That's all I asked you for. So anyway, check out the website, y'all. If y'all have not, again, go and check out. But it's just two. They gave him this big old bag for two bags of brownies. These tiny brownies. But check out the website. The link is attached to here. Also, the Linktree link is attached to the video too. And all you do is click on that Linktree link. It's going to take you to all the links that God's Day and me is a part of, which is Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter, Facebook, website, GodsDay81.com, and all the podcast platforms. We're on Spotify. This weekend, I'm really going to try to upload. I know what I forgot to. This weekend, I'm going to try to upload these episodes to the podcast, because I have a lot of them. a lot. I said I won't let them, but I got a lot of them. And then the website, the YouTube channel, which is Whispers in the Pews. Check out the YouTube channel. There are a lot of videos there, like quite a bit, and I still have some to upload to that. So look out for that too. Again, you want to order, pre-order your journal, you can pre-order your journal. Go to GodSay81.com, look under store. T-shirts and journals are there. The t-shirts are available now. The journals will be available. You can pre-order them now, but they should be back tomorrow or Saturday. As soon as they come in, I will ship those. They are pre-order. I will ship yours to you ASAP. Now, remember that Monday is a holiday, so it's Labor Day, so I won't be able to ship on Monday. But if it comes in after they close on Saturday, then it'll be Tuesday when I mail it. So between now and next week, you will have your journals for those that have pre-ordered. So preferably come in sooner than later. Anthony, we having baked fish and salad tonight. I baked some fish. So yeah, baked fish and salad tonight. So I pray that something today I said that was very great for y'all. This is the second video because the first one cut off. So go back and watch the other one. I pray it was something on that as well that I said that was in helping you to stay encouraged. Continue to read those blogs. If you ever get down and out, go back and watch those some blogs that we have done. Look at God. Won't he do it? I've been wanting Wingstop for 3 days, so we had Wingstop last night. Don't judge me. I was wanting Wingstop. So tonight we having, I baked fish and having salad. And my two brownies. My brownies. So anyway, go back and listen to the video. And then go, if you ever feeling down and out, you need some encourage, you need some help, go back and look at those blogs. Read those blogs on GodSay81.com. And if you have some, also you can go back and look at previous videos, lives that we have done. They're on YouTube. They're on the Guys Day page. They're on my page. So any of those that will help you to go further on, don't give up. Don't stop what you're doing. If it's good, if it's working, if it's for God, go for it. Don't let nobody change that. You already have an idea. You don't have to tell nobody your idea. Just do it. You'll find out later if it worked or not, but you don't need everybody's opinion about what God has given to you. It's not for them. It's for you. It's your season. It's your time. Go after that. Do that. Don't be afraid to step out there on faith. Folks telling you it's not going to work. It ain't going to be nothing. What you talking about doing ain't going to be worth anything. Don't even worry about it. Go forth. Conquer that. And then when they look at you, be like, oh, let them have that oh, that oh look. Like, oh, let them have it. It's fine. But dwell on what you're, do things that you're supposed to be doing. Don't worry about nobody else. Don't worry about what the naysayers have to say. You're going to always have that. The haters is a motivation. They hating on what you're doing. They talking about what you're doing. Let them, that's a motivation. If you're upset that I'm doing this little thing, watch what I do with what I got planned now. Let them talk. Let them be what they mean. They don't have no heaven or hell to put you in. They not going to help you with your business. So since they not, Let them, you don't have to listen to them. Do what you got to do. Do it for you and yours. Make sure you got God ahead of it. Make sure he's all involved in everything that you're doing. God's a good God. He's an amazing God. He loves you for everything that you're doing. He's watching you. He cares for you. Continue to stay pretty. Continue to stay beautiful. Continue to stay handsome. Don't come out of yourself. Don't change for nobody. Don't be somebody else because of what somebody else is doing. Stay you. The person you used to be, you're not that person anymore. God has some amazing things working for you, but you got to stay with it. Stay focused on that. Don't go back to that person you used to be. It's not even worth it. That's not even you no more. God has changed you, and he wants you to keep going forward, to look ahead of you. Don't look back. Those things God has working for you, let him continue to work them out for you. Let God to work those things out for you. The things that revenge that God is setting up for you, that you're trying to set up for somebody else, let God take care of that revenge for you. He can do greater with it than you can. Your revenge won't be as great as his. He has it all under control. He's already knowing what to do. Just let him work it out. He'll work it out. I'm going to go because I'm going to finish cooking and finish working. And I want y'all to have a great rest of y'all evening. I will be back tomorrow. Don't forget about the website, GodStay81.com, the YouTube channel, Whispers in the Pews, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, GodStay, or my name, Uncle Nick. And the email is UncleNick@gmail. That's mine, Sue. But GodStay81.com. GodStay81@gmail.com. All of those links are attached to this at the top of this video. Click on it, and you're more than welcome to browse around, follow, like, share. And thank y'all for y'all support. Thank y'all for tuning in. Thank y'all for being with me today. Go back and watch the first video. We have two videos for today, but the podcast is just going to be one. So go back and listen to the podcast as well. Have a great rest of y'all evening. Remember, God loves you. I love you. There's nothing you can do about it. Talk to y'all later, Whisperers. Bye.